knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
We have been discussing a number of olefination reactions, including the previous tutorial on the two-step Julia olefination. Now let's turn to what is perhaps the most widely used olefination reaction, the Horner-Emmons reaction, sometimes also referred to as the Horner-Wadsworth-Emmons reaction. This was invented by German chemist Leopold Horner in 1958 and perfected years later by American chemists William Wadsworth and William Emmons. The reaction consists of the addition of stabilized carbanions from phosphonates to aldehydes and ketones. Note that the reaction only works if these carbanions are not only stabilized by a phosphonate group, but also by an ester or another electron-withdrawing functionality, such as ketone, amide, or nitrile. As a general rule, the olefin produced is predominantly E. The reaction somewhat resembles the Wittig reaction, which we learned about much earlier in the series, in that a phosphorus-based group was used to stabilize the negative charge on the carbanion. But this resemblance is only superficial. For one thing, phosphonium salts are much more acidic than the corresponding phosphonates, in part because they are positively charged. And proton loss leads to a neutral species, an ilid. As a consequence, phosphonate anions are more basic than the corresponding phosphorus ilids, and also more nucleophilic. The reaction consists of two steps, like the Julia reaction. First, the anion forms. This nucleophile attacks the electrophilic carbonyl group to yield a beta-phosphonyl alkoxide. This first step is usually reversible, and therefore the step determining the stereochemistry is usually the next one, the syn elimination of the phosphate anion via this cyclic intermediate, which for the same torsional strain factors operating in the Julia reaction leads to the E olefin preferentially. So while there is sometimes a preference for the kinetic formation of the 3O adduct, this depends very much on the base and solvent used, and also the structure of the phosphonate group, where the stereoselectivity is best when the first step is reversible and the stereochemistry is decided by the slow step of the reaction, the fragmentation of the cyclic intermediate, in which the two bulky groups prefer to be anti to each other. The importance of the substituents on phosphorus can be appreciated by an important modification of the HWE reaction called the Still-Gennari modification. This was developed by Professor W. Clark Still, then a chemist at Columbia University, and Italian chemist Cesare Gennari, now a professor at the University of Milan. This modification achieves the synthesis of Z olefins with excellent stereoselectivity. The original paper by Still and Gennari has received over 1,000 citations and countless applications, as it nicely complements the Horner reaction under classical conditions. The main difference between the HWE reaction and the SG modification is the use of trifluoroethyl phosphonates instead of ethyl or methyl phosphonates. Typically, the base used is potassium hexamethyl disilazide. The reasons for the selectivity are not well understood, but it is assumed that due to the excellent electron-withdrawing ability of the fluorine-substituted phosphonate, the second step, the fragmentation, is quite fast. And this results in the first step not having time to reverse. This would mean that in this particular case, the selectivity is decided in the first step, the addition of the carbanion to the carbonyl group, and that the erythro intermediate is favored over 3O by a fairly large margin. The SG olefination is usually performed in THF at low temperatures, typically negative 78 degrees Celsius, which further enhances kinetic control of the reaction. It is not obvious why the erythro intermediate is favored to such large extent over the 3O. Some authors have proposed a coordinated approach to the beta-hydroxyphosphonate intermediate and a staggered alignment of the phosphonyl and alkyl groups, but this is rather speculative. After the surprising findings by Still and Gennari, many other phosphonate groups have been examined, and it is clear that there is a very smooth continuum in terms of E-selectivity as a function of phosphonate structure. But a detailed discussion of these results is beyond the scope of this tutorial. Both HWE reaction and SG protocols can be applied to simple ketones, and at times these reactions retain their high E or Z selectivity, at least for methyl ketones. Similarly, alpha-alkyl phosphonyl esters can also lead to high selectivity, especially when the alkyl group is the smallest possible, a methyl group. Stereoselective olefin synthesis is usually a key step in the synthesis of natural macrolide antibiotics, as these compounds have multiple olefinic bonds. As an example of these widespread macrocyclic compounds, let's take arcozolide A. This is a complex structure and quite a challenge to prepare. It features a 24-membered ring, 8 stereogenic centers, and 7 CC double bonds, of which 5 are E and 2 are Z. The Horner-Wadsworth-Emmons reaction is an excellent tool to stitch this together. Indeed, Professor Dirk Mensch at the University of Bonn in Germany reported a total synthesis of this molecule by making heavy use of the olefination reactions we just discussed. Without going into the details of the entire synthesis, it is useful to take a look at how Professor Mensch prepared the fragment in red within the macrocycle. The first step is a Still-Gennari reaction using reactant A and affording the desired ester in the Z configuration. Esters can be easily reduced to aldehydes by a variety of methods, and in this case the resulting aldehyde is again reacted with phosphonate A to yield yet another Z olefin. This method is iterative and can be used to put together very complex molecules. Of course, when the double bond is E, the classical HWE conditions can be used. Thus, the Horner-Wadsworth-Emmons reaction is one of the most popular tools in the synthesis of complex chemical substances, and the Still-Gennari modification yielding Z olefins complements this already popular reaction to make it one of the most useful and important tools in modern organic synthesis.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.